What up guys, it's Kirtan Singh here and I'm back with a brand new Let's Talk video. Today, we're talking about my personal favourite Bollywood film of all time, Kuch Kuch Hota Hai.
Pyar. Pyar dosti hai. Agar wo meri sabse achhi dost nahi ban sakti, to main usse kabhi pyar kar hi nahi sakta. Kyunki dosti bina to pyar hota hi nahi. Simple. Pyar dosti hai.
Believe it or not, this year is the 20th anniversary of Kuch Kuch Hota Hai. It actually happened in October, and I was going to make this video then, but I was promoting my film the night before, and I had a few other videos planned which I had to get out during the period of November. So, now here we are in December, and I am releasing this Let's Talk video. The film is directed by first-time writer and director Karan Johar. It stars Shah Rukh Khan as Rahul, Rani Mukherjee as Tina, Kajol as Anjali, and Sana Saeed as young Anjali, a child Anjali, two separate characters there. The synopsis of the film is as follows. A dying woman, Tina, asks her daughter Anjali to play matchmaker for her father and his former best friend, Anjali. Yes, there are two people named Anjali, and it's so weird. Anyway, apart from that one really weird name, our film is amazing. It's my personal favorite film. I love anytime Shah Rukh Khan and Kajol are on screen together. It's wonderful. In any movie, especially this movie itself. So yeah, in any movie, Shah Rukh Khan and Kajol are perfect on screen. Adding Rani there is also a delight. And Sana Saeed does a great job as a child itself. I honestly cried just before the intermission where they finish up the story where Kajol leaves on the train, leaving Shah Rukh Khan and Rani together. It's actually a beautiful scene. That's actually my personal favorite scene of the whole film. The symbolism there is very good because we have Kajol. I'm just going to refer to Kajol as Kajol, not as Anjali. And Sana's character Anjali as Anjali, just to simplify that. So Kajol's leaving Rahul and Tina at the train station. She's going away because she can't take not being with Rahul. So what she does, she's wearing all white, symbolism of purity. She has this red sari and she throws it off the train. And it's meant to be her saying that this is my love for you and I'm passing it on to Tina. You see the sari fall in front of Tina's face and it's such a beautiful scene. You can see the emotion in Kajol's face and in Rahul's face and Tina's face. Oh, I just love that scene so much. And the second half of the film itself leans itself more to traditional aspects of Bollywood film, emphasizing the fact that a woman needs to be culturally intelligent and more religious to be wife material, which is a meaning and idea which I personally don't agree with, but it's what the film basically says. And I'll go into more detail about that and how the film portrays that in a future video. But for now, that's a symbolism which the film really nails down. Guess who's here? Salma Khan, I don't know his character's name, but he's there and he's actually going to get married to Kajol, which is really weird seeing Shah Rukh Khan and Salma Khan in the same movie, just for that fact alone. And he's really sidelined. He's like a character who's not even main. He's just there and you don't really care for him. Salma Khan, that is. Shah Rukh Khan, Rahul, you care for him a lot. And basically, by the end of the film, Kajol and Rahul, their love reignites. They actually end up together, and Salma Khan is the better man. He doesn't force Kajol to marry him, even though they've been engaged. He hands her over, although forcibly, by grabbing her arm and dragging her, not literally dragging her, but pulling her towards Rahul so that they can be together. It's therefore a misdirection, thinking that, oh, he's going to force her to marry him. But he doesn't, he's a better man, and he gives it away to Rahul. There's one scene from this film itself which I hate so much. And it's not related to the meaning of a woman has to be religious to be a good wife. It's a depiction of a Sikh in this film which is so stereotypically poor and infuriating with how it's done. There's a scene where Rahul and his mother go to watch his child Anjali perform doing this 1 minute recital scene. And there's a Sikh friend behind him, and the Sikh has a wife as well. And he is so annoying. He is talking so much. He's acting like a typical, stereotypical man from the pinned from the town out of nowhere, and he's so annoying during the scene. He talks so loudly, you can clearly see how annoyed Rahul, his mother, and even the Sikh's wife is. Seriously, they're emphasizing the fact that this Sikh guy is an annoying man who's over the top, loud, and irritating to everyone. It's how Sikhs are depicted so often, and it infuriates me so much. And seeing it in this film, which I love, just makes it even worse. But it is one scene, stereotypically done. It's a product of its age for the most part, although it still happens today in Bollywood films. It is easily the worst scene of the film itself. But we do need to carry on and go into some good things. I need to mention how good the main theme is. It is so beautiful. Just take a listen. There's nothing much like it, to be honest. So yeah, if you don't find that melody beautiful, there's something wrong. It's honestly such a great theme, and Curtin even used it as a theme for his production company later on. In the end, honestly, this film is amazing. If you haven't seen it, go and watch it. Just remember, it's a Bollywood film, so you can't go into it expecting it to be like a Hollywood film. It has all these different conventions and storytelling techniques, and there's a specific way to watch a Bollywood film. So if you haven't seen one before, just be prepared for how different it can be. Overall, the film has great acting, great music, and is very well directed. Apart from a few scenes here and there which I've pointed out, which bring the film down a little and the meaning of the film is a little poor for how it's aged, the film still holds up for the most part. It's a great film, enjoyable film, and it's telling a really strong and romantic tale. In my opinion, it's the best Bollywood film of all time. That's mainly because I grew up watching it. Honestly, I would give it a 9.6 out of 10. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed that video. Make sure you hit that like button, subscribe to my channel for more videos. Let me know what you thought about this video and the film itself in the comment section down below. Make sure you check out my last video and make sure you support me on my Patreon account. I'll catch you guys next time.